This is the wrap up for Wednesday, November 11th, Armistice Day, Remembrance Day. And we have seen the dollar making some retracement across the board. Euro dollar, for instance, returning into range despite the fall of the government in Portugal. We have worries about Japan that may be in recession, perhaps more action from the Bank of Japan. It's unclear about that. Data so far, we had Chinese industrial output rising less than expected, only 5.6%. Australian dollar remains sort of depressed in range, still holding above 70. Import prices in the United States fell. RBN said not worried about the exchange rate, worried about other stuff, and that means a stable Kiwi. Today's big event right now, soon after the show, we have employment data from the UK. And most important thing to watch is wages. Let's see if they rise above 3%. Big event for today, perhaps the most important event, is a speech from ECB President Mario Draghi, 1:15 GMT, just at the wake of the US session, and this time the US and Canada are having a bank holiday. If Draghi says something important on weak liquidity, we could have a bigger impact. At night, we have the Australian employment data, very important, of course, for the Aussie. Okay, we're expecting an improvement in employment data over there. Okay, charts. Euro dollar well in range. 1710 support, further support 106.60, resistance 108.10, and then 109. Pound dollar currently sliding in range, 151.10 support, 150 lower support, 150 to 153 resistance. I'm a bit optimistic for the pound. Dollar yen recovering from the fall, 123.60 is resistance, followed by 124, 122 low support. Dollar CAD currently 132.70 in the narrow range of 132.40 to 132.80. Strong resistance 134.60, low support 132. Aussie dollar, of course, 70. The 70 line is looming below 70.65, still some kind of resistance, followed by 71.10. And the Kiwi dollar entrenched in range, 65 support, 65.60 weak resistance, followed by 66.15. Okay, that's the wrap for today. I see we have more questions. Fabian says, but there are no banks to act in the speeches, right? Well, it's not a holiday like Christmas or Easter or something like that. It's a normal bank holiday. So some banks are operating, and we have banks in the UK, in Europe operating at least the beginning of the US session. So it's not that markets are closed, it's just much lower liquidity. So we do have just less action, but it doesn't mean no action. Okay, so I hope that answered the question. Sarap asks about pound CAD. Let's look about that like that. It's your favorite currency pair, I think. And yeah, we've seen that it's quite interesting. So it's above 2, the round number, 2, almost 201. Resistance 201, so we're almost there. Currently just below resistance, support 12. The round number of 2 is sort of more psychological. Oh, it's also some kind of support. Further support, I see it right here at 199.10, and further resistance at 202.70. These are the lines I'm looking at. If we have a break above this level, if we have a good employment report in the UK, especially wages, you could see it break and head all the way towards 202.70. That's the next line to watch. If we have a weak report in 45 minutes or so, you could see it tumble back in within the range towards 2. So these are the levels I'm watching now at pound CAD. Okay, so thank you very much. That's it for today. Thank you very much for coming.